FM21 is here. FM21 is here. I don't need my headphones on because FM21 does not require sound. Cool. Football Manager 2021. I've only had Football Manager 20 for like 2020 for like 5 months, but we move. I'm recording this as a YouTube series as well. I'm going to just stream it and cut it up into parts. I'll try and keep an eye on the time. Try and keep it to 30-minute parts. Probably only do an hour or so today because I'll be cracking on with some zombies later. But if this game ever loads, you can't change the mentals higher. Okay, you can only go the other what Cotrian attributes higher. So we're gonna go probably a couple more in all of them, to be honest. We've got gives 1 point left. Let's do working with youngsters. Right. We're going to start playing. We are here. FM21. It's only the beta, obviously, but Arsenal hire Harris. Arsenal today confirmed the appointment of Stan Harris as the club's new manager. Eyebrows have been raised in the world of football at the appointment of the 22-year-old, who has recently spent time away from club football, and he is sure to face plenty of questions as he faces the media for the first time at the Emirates Stadium. Harris put pen to paper on a 3-year deal worth 75k a week. 75k a week. That takes me like 4 years to earn that. He replaces Mikel Arteta, of course. Lacks a reputation, but intrigue nonetheless. Media prediction fifth. That is very kind. Finish eighth. We finish eighth. Third round FA Cup. We enter that. Okay, cool. We're in the Europa League, of course. This is apparently our. Is this our best? This is our best 11. I kind of agree. I'm not sure about Mari. I'm also not sure about three at the back, but overall, I'm for it. I'm for it. I'm listening. Obviously, we got Ceballos on loan. That's the only thing that came in. Well, that's the only transfer obligations. Attacking football, entertaining football. Players under the age of 18 for the future. Cool. That's a big one. And develop players using the club's youth system. Okay, we got this. We got this. I'm excited. It looks clean as well this year. Looks clean. Schedule. We're gonna do all this, of course. Let's go. I'm so excited every time. Oh man. Players only asked last year of contract. Right, obviously we've got a few players here. Mesut Ozil, who I do think I'm going to try and fit in the team. Let's see what his stats are like. I mean, look at him, he's still so good. We're not about to get any money for him, I don't think. I'm going to may not react well. I'm going to either try and play him or sell him. If I can't sell him, I'm going to actually try and play him because I do like him. Oh, we can ex we can ex we're gonna yeah we are going to extend Balogun's contract. It's a lot of players, right? Should we go straight into the tactics? Let's go straight into the tactics. So, what have we got this year? Exactly the same. It's recommending Gegenpress tiki-taka or vertical tiki-taka. He's still got good physicals. He's actually a really good player. Look at that. Look at their mentals. That's crazy. 100k a week, apparently, which is all right. So, I think that's going to be our starting 11. We will rotate the midfield. We've obviously got some good players. We've got some okay players, should I say. We are going to make sure about Lacazette still gets plenty of game time. I don't really like having a goalkeeper on the bench, so I'm just going to avoid that for now. We do obviously need Kolasinac, Maitland-Niles. Try and make sure I've got good positions. So we don't need another right back because we've got Maitland-Niles on the bench. So obviously Xhaka goes in. Saka has to go in. We're already on six. We're already on six. Well, obviously Lacazette has to be there. And then we've literally got one spot left for either Ozil, Nketiah, Nelson or Willock. Now, we don't really need Nketiah on the bench. There's a lot of players there that, aren't getting in the team. Obviously, Socrates. Oh, it's not good. And actually, registration's going to be so hard. I feel like I'm already 16 minutes into stream and I haven't done a tactic. Expectations, we're just going to accept it. We're going to get on with it. We need. So what we expected? We expected to qualify for the Euro Cup, so finish in top six. Reach a semi-final FA Cup. I think we can do that. Community Shield, don't care. Reached a final of the Euro Cup, which could be difficult depending on who gets knocked out of the Champions League. And no one cares about the Carabao Cup. Wow. Within 3 years' time, we'd be challenging for the Premier League. Right. We're almost there. We're almost there. Handle touch on instructions, yes. Team talks, yes. Friendly matches, yes. I do want to do that as well. Cool. Right. So responsibilities are done. Injury update. We've got Callum Chambers out for 2 to 3 months, of course. Pablo Mari out for 2 to 4 months. And Mustafi out for 2, 3 to 4 months. So we're a little bit light defensively, but we've got a hold in and we've got a couple of players who can step in and do a job. Obviously, crazy transfer window. They want Mari to be our vice-captain. No chance, mate. No chance. He's Spanish. I didn't know he was Spanish. I thought he was Brazilian. That's awkward. Apparently, Reece Nelson has one of the best players as his potential, which is very interesting. I'm not a fan. But he'll get rotational players. He'll get lots of cup games. He doesn't really make it into my even on my bench for the I can't even know what I'm talking about. In my matchday Premier League squad, he doesn't really make it on my bench, but anyway, this has changed a little bit. So we're in our meeting room. Very, very nice. I want to take the opportunity to introduce myself to you as a new Arsenal manager. That is me. I do want to do that. All right. Aubameyang, on behalf of the team, I'd like to welcome you and look forward to playing under your management. Well, that's very kind. Squad. I don't really know what we need to improve. I'm not happy with the squad. But it's not awful. If anything, we can give game time to Nelson and Nketiah when it comes to going forward. We can give game time to Maitland-Niles in defence or in midfield. Like, we've got an okay squad. I don't really need to improve for now. Again, the midfield's fine. I do want to reduce the size of the squad, but I don't want to make any promises like that. Okay, they're happy with the youth. They're happy with that. Sounds pretty good to him. So I've seen there's different gestures you can do this year. I don't really want to reduce. Oh, they didn't react well to that. Okay. Alright, no more. We don't want to make any more promises. It supports us to set. We need to set some sensible goals. Alright, I think we can qualify for the Euro Cup. Yes, everyone's happy with that. Of course they are. Pump fist, exactly what I'm after. Let's go! I feel like with this new gesture system, we have to actually do it, you know? I'm going to have to actually act it out. Come on, guys, we can qualify for the Euro Cup. Of course we can. Pump fist. I'll be aiming to reach the final. That's sensible. Let's go. Outstretch arms. That's exactly what I'm after. Let's go. This is going to be so good. I love it. Sure. Let's get to the final. Just casually. All right. Everyone's happy. They're content. Everyone's happy with the code of conduct. So, we're just going to outstretch arms. Positive, guys. I'm glad we're all on the same page. So that's that. We've players are happy with the promises. That's very good. Very happy with that. And cool. That is fine. Players are overall pretty happy. We'll leave our meeting. And we'll continue on. Now, let's have a look at finances, because that's a big one. That's a big one. So we've got 137 million. Nothing in the transfer budget, but to be honest, that's fine. We're guaranteed a minimum of 46 million next season, which is okay. Do you know what? I'm actually, for the most part, quite happy with that. I am, of course, going to try and get rid of Ozil, but I don't know if it's going to happen. Therefore, I'm not counting on it. We're going to attend the press conference because I've not done it this year. So we'll give it a go. Give it a chance. So, this is cool. I like how they got like 90-minute sport Bible 442. It's very cool. All right, let's kick off this meeting. Start the press conference. So, how does it feel to be the new Arsenal manager? Smile warmly. I'm very proud, very excited, and very keen to see what we can do. We're going to be doing this the whole time. You know, we're going to be doing the gestures this whole time. As a big fan of the club, it must be a dream come true. It's a very special day for me. I've dreamt of this for years. Even though you're young. Okay, all right. I'm going to disagree. So, all right. Plank. All right, cool. I'm just going to try and go through this because I'm not really a massive fan of the press conferences. I'm glad they've changed it, but it's the same as usual, really, isn't it? Apart from the gestures. Young talent. How do you intend to factor that in day-to-day management? Okay, so everyone who deserves a chance is going to get their chance. That's how we roll. What do you think of the Arsenal squad? Ooh, okay. All right. I don't know. Yeah, they're going to have to show me day in and day out. Have you been able to meet them? Yes. How important is it that we strive? How important are the fans? Okay. Well, we're going to outstretch arms. I already know how good this fan base is, and it's going to be a huge part of the success we have. Where do you want to take the club? We need to aim high. Oh, wait. Actually, we're going to do long-term success. That's all that matters. What's your approach on the training ground? Oof. Got to be a balance. It's got to be a balance. I like Maitland Niles. He's not really... he's so bang average at everything. That's the only problem I have with him. But, yeah, we're not going to go too much. I don't see why not. Do you feel the squad could do a strengthening? I do want to say to him, I'm not prepared to talk about it right now. Because that's fair. Or do you want to? I don't want to say I'm going to get rid of him. Alright, we don't want to discuss that. It's not fair to discuss that. How do you see your management style? I don't know. Okay, yeah, that's fine. You've taken a charge of Cedric. I don't... I'll be looking to take advantage of him. Do you know what? I'm fine with that. I don't really need him. So if anyone's interested, come at me with an offer for Cedric. Yeah, we can't... Yeah, sure. We can't prioritise one competition over the other. We've got to make sure the Europa League and the Premier League, we go for it well. They don't think I did a very good job. I mean, I thought it was a good press conference. I thought it was brilliant. Okay. Xhaka's getting skinned. That's good, because he's in the second team, right? So that's a good thing. Yeah, their XG... Wow, our XG is pretty bad. Okay, fine. I'm not angry. I'm just disappointed with you. That's horrible. All right, I guess we... hands on hips. Now, I don't want to copy Loki Doki, because... But I might, a little bit. hands on hips. Hands on hips. Everyone expecting you to have a much better second half. Okay. Fine. I like the interface, but it's going to take some getting used to. Like, it's different. It's definitely different. You can see here. Oh, Ceballos. Oh, yeah. Oh, is that, what happened here? Oh, J-Ray, you dropped a follow. Thank you so much for that. I really appreciate it. I don't know what that animation is. Don't judge me. just don't judge me. Don't judge me. But yeah, no, the game's cool. The match engine looks really, really smooth. I like the match, especially. That looks really cool. The rest of it is fairly similar, just some change of graphics. But there's a few little cool introductions, so... yeah, I like this a lot. I don't really like the changing the tactics and changing the substitutions mid-game. This is way too cluttered for me. This doesn't make sense. That's the only problem I have, but... It's only a friendly. Not too bothered. Alright. Well, we won. We came back. Crystal, you can do hands together. So you can do a hand... I'm just... Hands in pockets, hands on hips. Fresh arms. This is so cool. We'll talk to the room. Hands on hips. Just to... just a... For a pre-season match, that was good. I'm pleased. Oh, you gotta love it. Right, cool. We'll go with that. It was a good comeback again, but it was the second team. We expected to win. But yeah, it's all good. I think what we'll do, because obviously, like I said, I am recording this as a YouTube video as well. So we'll leave the first episode there. It'll be quite a long one. I'm going to cut out some of it anyway. It'll be quite a long one, but thank you very much for watching this. If you are watching this now on YouTube, if you want to catch streams, please do stop by twitch.tv/stanharris97. Be streaming Support Manager. I'm going to be streaming mostly Cold War, I'm going to be honest. But we'll be doing Support Manager as well here and there. Because I do love Football Manager, but Cold War is Cold War. And also Black Ops 3 Zombies. I do love a bit of Black Ops 3. Alright guys, I'm going to interrupt the end of the episode with a quick outro. I'm just recording... Well, it's actually the second time recording this because I forgot to set up the microphone. So we're going to go again. This is obviously the end of part one. So basically a little outro and a bit more of information for you. So obviously I recorded this as a stream and I've cut it up into highlights, and I felt that I didn't want to waffle too much. I was waffling quite a bit, obviously talking to the chat, so I wanted to keep it quite concise, keep it interesting, and I've got down to 17 and a half minutes roughly. So I was thinking, oh, okay, it's not really long enough for an open episode, so I'm just gonna do a really quick outro and give you an update of what I'm going to do for this series. So episode 2 is going to be very similar. I've got about 2 hours worth of stream footage. I'm going to try and cut down to about a half hour, give or take. And that'll be episode 2. And from there, it'll be very different. That's just the first section while streaming. I think what I'm going to do now for episode 2... for episode 3, we're going to basically be playing some games off camera, coming back for one or two games, depending on what the games are. Obviously, do a roundup of the previous games and stuff like that. So I've actually recorded, obviously, one and two are already sorted because of the stream. Episode 3, I'm prepared to... I just need to record it. I've played some games off camera already. I'm sort of mid-October at this point. So that's just to keep you updated. The format of the videos will change. We've got two episodes, the first two episodes, stream highlights, and it'll be a more sort of YouTube-based series from then on out. There will be times where I still stream it, and I may incorporate that somewhere within the series. Maybe we just do pre-season as a stream. I don't know. We'll have to see. I haven't really decided for next season anyway yet. But yeah, it's just... Basically, this is a little update just to let you know that if you are interested in watching some streams, it won't always be Football Manager. In fact, it's probably less likely Football Manager than anything else. But it'll be Black Ops 3... Zombies, it will be Cold War. They're the sort of two things I'm streaming the most at the moment. Please do check me out on twitch.tv/stanharris97. If you want to see more Football Manager content, you want to see any other content from myself, please subscribe to the YouTube channel. Please like the video, it's really appreciated. It just feels good. You know, it don't get likes very often. When you do get a like, it just feels good. Even just a little something. So do appreciate that. And yeah, I hope you are looking forward to more content, because I am sure looking forward to making it. So I hope you stick around. So take care and goodbye.